I started, one thing that David and the studio spoke to me about was Emma is not sure she wants to come back to do another Potter.
Harry!
People definitely forget what she took on and how gracefully she did it. Darren and Rupert, they had each other. I had my cronies. Whereas Emma was not younger, she was by herself.
I did find a diary entry that was kind of like... I can see that at times I was lonely.
We never talked about it on the film, because we were all just kids. As a 14-year-old boy, I was never going to turn around to another 14-year-old and be like, hey, how you doing? Like, is everything okay?
Sword of the Phoenix.
That's when things started getting spicy for all of us.
But you considering putting out, I never really spoke to you about this.
Yeah, I think I was scared.
Yeah.
I don't know if you ever felt like it got to a tipping point when you were like, this is kind of forever now.
Yeah, no, I had moments like that kind of all the way through.
I also had kind of similar feelings to Emma, kind of contemplating what life would be like if I called it a day. But we never really spoke about it. I guess we were just kind of going through it at our own pace. We were kind of in the moment at the time. It just didn't really occur to us. We were all kind of there, probably having similar feelings.
Yeah, the fame thing had finally hit home in a big way. No one had to convince me to see it through. The fans genuinely wanted you to succeed, and we all genuinely have each other's backs. How great is that?
It's always amazing meeting people. You know, these films mean so much to them because they kind of grew up alongside us and helped them with some really difficult things in their lives. And I'm just very proud